And it is the F-16 AM Fighting Falcon.
Opponent, but now.
Serbia, more recently in Afghanistan and the Baltic Air Policing Mission, and NATO's Operation Unified Protector in Libya in 2011. More recently, they've been performing reconnaissance and surveillance missions over Iraq and Syria. Now, in at the slow for the F-16 AM's High Alpha Pass. Certainly near it, mark 0.9, with full reheat and unloaded as he is here. The aircraft accelerating at 20 knots per second.
As a lot of people have been asking, how comes when the aircraft is going fast, you can't hear it coming until it's virtually on top of you? Well, if you bear in mind, the speed of sound is about 660 miles per hour or knots, and the aircraft is doing just a little bit under that, so the speed never actually gets far in front of the aircraft. So the two virtually arrive at the same time.
Of course, multinational cooperation very much in vogue, and the Dutch and Belgian F-16s share quick reaction alert, QRA, duties across the three Benelux countries. Also, the Belgians and Dutch, their F-16 communities work together within what's known as the EPAF, Expeditionary Air Wing. EPAF stands for European Participating Air Forces. They're the European NATO countries that came together in the 1970s to buy the F-16. An example would be joint Belgian and Dutch ground crew supporting one country's aircraft on operations. Vador then coming in for not a landing, but a touch and go. Shoulder to the left for his dedication pass. A really nice opportunity to see the upper surfaces on this very attractively painted dark Falcon. And you might have noticed that on the horizontal stabilizers at the aircraft. On one side, the tip is painted with Belgian flag colours, and then the other side has got the RAF 100 logo on it, and that's because Vader has the aircraft painted, I don't think he does it quite himself, has that part of the aircraft painted with the flag of whichever country he's visiting for a display. I think at Cosford earlier in the year he had the Union flag on it, but obviously for this occasion they've gone for the RAF 100 logo. Of course, military cooperation between the UK and Belgium dates back a very, very long time. And certainly in the skies over Belgium in 1918, the newly formed RAF during the last months of World War I saw some of its first actions. A superb contribution to the RIAT flying programme from Capitaine Aviateur Stefan Darte on the Belgian Air Component F-16 Fighting Falcon. And we're now going to bring the F-35A Lightning II back in from its display at Duxford. And he's going to perform a run and break into the circuit before landing.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, just a reminder that if you're planning to leave the showground by foot, please do so by the red exit, the red exit only, and the yellow exit is not available for your own safety, so please do abide by that. Thinking ahead to departure, why would you want to? There's still